The Pinwheel reminds us that every child deserves a healthy and happy childhood. I would like to thank everyone for joining us for our annual Child Abuse Prevention Walk and Pinwheel Garden Ceremony. My name is Xavier Evans. I am the supervisor for the Early Prevention Unit, and it's really good to finally be outside again and to celebrate this occasion with everyone. So thank you all for coming. First person up on this podium is our mayor. Mayor Alexander is going to come up and deliver our proclamation for Child Abuse Prevention Month. If everyone can give him a hand as he comes to the podium.
All right. Well, thank you very much. So the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to ask these wonderful volunteers to come stand behind me. We want to make sure that you guys come on up here. Yeah, come on, and with the banner, why don't you be in front with the banner? Yeah, if we're going to do it, we're going to do it right. So this is a City of Norfolk proclamation. I am glad to have with me the City Manager, Dr. Chip Feiler, Assistant City Manager, Trista Pope, Denise Gallup, and all of the many volunteers and partners with us today. Whereas child abuse and neglect is a serious problem affecting every segment of our community. And whereas child abuse can have lifelong psychological, emotional, and physical effects that can have lifelong consequences for victims of abuse, which can affect healthy growth and development. And whereas meaningful connections and partnerships created between child welfare, education, health, community and faith-based organizations, businesses, and law enforcement agencies help effective child abuse prevention activities. And whereas our children are our most valuable resources and will shape the future of the City of Norfolk. And whereas we acknowledge that we must work together as a community to increase awareness about child abuse and promote the social and emotional well-being of children and families in safe, stable, nurturing environment, and whereas prevention remains the best defense for our children and families. Now, therefore, I, Kenneth Cooper Alexander, Mayor of the City of Norfolk, hereby proclaim the month of April 2022 as Child Abuse Prevention Month in the City of Norfolk, and urge all citizens to recognize this month by dedicating ourselves to the task of improving the quality of life for all children and families to strengthen the communities we live in, given under my hand this 11th day of April, 2022 in the City of Norfolk.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm telling you, this is such an important and exciting day as we come together as a community, human services, all of our community partners. We have CASA here. We have the Hampton Roads. Where's my Hampton Roads people? Well, thank you, right here in the front. We have all kinds of partners from the YWCA, our own internal programs like our neighborhood services office. Everyone is, oh, and let's not forget the police department is here. And so it just goes to show you that each person here today believes that there is no excuse for child abuse, that communities are safer when children are safe.
Good afternoon, Mayor Alexander, Dr. Fowler, and to all our esteemed guests and beloved citizens of Norfolk. I bring you greetings from the Norfolk Department of Human Services Child Protective Services Unit, and under the leadership of our own Denise Gallup and her esteemed team of associate directors. 2019 was the last time we were able to gather here together, y'all. I am truly grateful to see so many faces that were here with us the last time we gathered to spread the word. I want to provide you with a few brief statistics, and I promise you I won't belabor the time. During the year of 2020, in a time like many of us had never seen before, our nation literally became to an abrupt halt. We stopped dead in our tracks. Child welfare workers, however, continue to persevere in this country. Woo! Despite the pandemic in 2020, approximately 2 million children in this country received prevention services because of the assessed need determined by CPS. Approximately 1.2 million children received post-responsive services from our prevention, preservation, and foster care units. And lastly, during our fiscal year in 2020, fewer than one quarter, that's 21.8% of our nation's children confirmed for abuse and neglect were able to remain in their home because of the preventative services that were placed by none other than our child welfare workers. Give yourselves a hand, ladies. Yay! Every year we recognize this time of the month as the sound of alarm to prevent child abuse. During this time, we take extra time to raise awareness and promote change, and all of that is amazing and it's very, very commendable. But we must recognize that there is now more than ever a call to action. Every day of every month of every year, I challenge each and every one of you here and within the sound of my voice to make a personal declaration to keep our children safe. Make it your personal declaration to save our children, to save our future, and yes, save our lives. But remember, the path of prevention is a lot easier than the restoration road to recovery. Thank you and have a safe one.
Thank you for that. Next we have Ms. Roxy Hoven. She is our director for our court appointed special advocates, CASA. CASA volunteers are everyday people appointed by a judge to speak up for abused and neglected children in our courts.
All right, I'm going. Y'all had to make me go past her. Are you kidding me? I would like to say that she stole my speech. But seriously, thank you so much for letting me be a part of this, for letting our team come and walk with you and actually work with you through year after year of challenging cases where you're so kind and accommodating to our volunteers and our work as we bear witness to the children that are in the court system, that do go before judges and tell their stories to the judges. Y'all have been such a dream team to work with, and I appreciate you. But every year that I get a chance to come down here on this day, and this day, I do not want to forget what this day is and what COVID has done to this world. Every day on this day, I'd like to remind all of us that prevention and CPS is where you invest in families. We want to talk about investing in families. Invest in families. Invest in the Norfolk Department of Human Services. Invest in prevention care. Invest in these workers who silently go about their job when we're all at home doing the unthinkable, making sure that families have what they need and children have what they need and that they're safe and that they're looked out for and that they know that their community, their city of Norfolk, is not forgetting them. And so please, investing in families means investing in these people right here. So give yourself another round of applause and keep your chin up. And thank you all. Thank you all.
Well, thank you so much. Thank you.
Yeah.
And before we do the Pinwheel Garden, I just want to again acknowledge a few of our community partners that did participate in our walk today. Again, we had CASA. We also had, of course, Norfolk Human Services, all the super workers who work tirelessly to prevent child abuse and neglect and keep families together. We have Gear Recovery, a nonprofit organization where their mission is to give everyone an advantage towards resilient recovery. We have Hampton Roads Community Health Center, focuses on providing high quality, comprehensive primary behavioral and dental care services to meet families' healthcare needs. They also assist with enrollment. We have the YWCA Southampton Roads. For nearly 40 years, the YWCA of Southampton Roads has run its emergency shelter, providing the only place of refuge for families escaping domestic and sexual violence in the city of Norfolk. We also have CHKD, our Child Advocacy Center, where they provide expert forensic, mental health, and advocacy services to children who may have experienced maltreatment and trauma. We also had -9 to 5, which utilizes a variety of community stakeholders dedicated to improving the lives of our region's youngest residents and in their families. So again, I want to thank everyone that participated in this ceremony today. The Pinwheels for Prevention campaign kicks off in April as Child Abuse Prevention Month in Norfolk and across the country. The pinwheel reminds us that every child deserves a healthy and happy childhood.
Who needs a pinwheel?
We know that adverse childhood experiences, trauma, violence, and toxic stress hurts our youngest and most vulnerable citizens. We know it can impair healthy development, learning, and success later in life. We also know that there is power in prevention. Healthy children and families are the building blocks for safe and thriving communities.
Safe children!
If we want to prevent abuse and neglect, we must work together to educate and support parents who are struggling, overwhelmed, or unable to manage. The Pinwheel Garden symbolizes our commitment to protecting children and strengthening families. We stand together as advocates to make prevention a priority for this community. Every child in Norfolk deserves a safe and happy childhood. Thank you for joining us today and for your support in promoting prevention as a priority in our community.